First of all, I want to apologize because I can never remember the three gentlemen's names from Lionel, so I have to read them off of a piece of paper. The gentleman behind me is Don Reese. Gentleman right here is Matt Ashba. And the other gentleman in the back is Brian Kunkel. It's a good Dutch name, Kunkel. Kunkel, you know how they say in Kutztown, Kunkel. Anyway, they're here to tell you all about the new products and things coming from Lionel, and I know you've all been waiting to hear this, so I'm going to shut up and let these guys take over.
And Carol, we want to, I think Carol's supposed to come up and receive this
gift.
Where is Carol? Are you going to do that first?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, we'll do that. Well, while we're waiting on Carol, it's great to be back again. These 6 months seem to roll around really quickly, but this is with Matt and I, and the same as Ryan, it's always a highlight for us to come to the Toy Train Museum because this kicks off New York for us. This is the first event where we get a chance to show everybody what we've been doing back at Lionel in the last year and especially the last 6 months. So we're excited about being able to show all of you the new product that we're going to show you today. And I want to just thank all of you for coming. Because if you weren't here, we wouldn't be here. So we really appreciate you guys coming in for our little presentation. Carol, on behalf of Lionel Trains, it's my pleasure to present to the museum this beautiful AC6000 CSX diesel locomotive. So we present it to you and sure hope that many, many of the visitors here will be able to enjoy it. So you're very welcome to have this. Okay. So, here, you go down the stairs and I'll hand it to you. Of course, this locomotive has everything, without me going through a long list of features, everything that we put into a diesel locomotive is in that CSX A6000. Now I'd like to bring Matt up and we'll start showing you some of the new stuff we're doing. We invite all of you to come to our booth in the Orange Hall because this is just kind of the tip of the iceberg that we have. We can't bring everything, but we have lots of new stuff in our booth. So Matt, up to you.
Thank you, Jaydon. Well, I would like to also say thank you for all of you for taking the time to come here. It is one of our high points of York, and as Jaydon pointed out, it really gets us rolling whenever we come here, and it always gets us rolling in the right way. Thanks to the TCA, too, and happy 35th to the Toy Museum. Let's move on to some specifics here, some new products. Like Jaydon said, we can't bring everything, but we did pull some stuff that really it's new to Jaydon and I as well, as far as some of this just having arrived from overseas. The fresh is still wet, so to speak, on some of them. Before I get into some of the actual product, I want to make sure that everybody is well aware and clear that not only do we have our ready-to-run catalog for 2012 and our signature C1 catalog for 2012, we've also now isolated the American Flyer line and given it its own island and attention. So we're really excited about being able to spotlight the American Flyer line in this way. And hopefully you've had a chance to go through the catalog a little bit, but we are continuing what we started last few years with some of the nice scale, 1/64th scale pieces for American Flyer. So in addition to the U-33 and the Challenger, you'll see in this new catalog here, the Y-3 style steam locomotive, as well as an SD70 ACE. And both of those are scale size and brand new tooling. Are there signs over there somewhere back there? They're probably still in the back. We also, of course, have our Christmas catalog that will be coming up, and that is in the process right now. That's going to be available very soon. I'd like to start out by mentioning a few things that are coming up in that Christmas catalog. One is one that we have cataloged already in the past, and we've held back on that because of some time it's taken to solidify getting this produced, and it is the U.S.-made boxcars. I'm sure many of you are happy to know that Lionel is continuing to move forward with bringing back some of our production to the States. Presidential boxcars. These are the first samples, the first time they've been shown as well, that they have been made in the United States. These are the first samples from our a Michigan production unit that we have. These will be produced very soon, and they will be produced this year. So you'll be seeing these recataloged in our Christmas catalog as sort of a stocking stuffer section. But these are the Mount Rushmore original four presidential boxcars with Lincoln, Jefferson, Washington, and Roosevelt. They will have a different style packaging that allows you to, there's a platform on there and you can see through the top a little bit more. But in any case, it'll be the Lionel name, the Lionel orange, distinctive box, and made in the USA. As we move forward with this, those cars, you will see other types of cars enter the U.S.-made line, and as much as we can do here, we will. Another thing that's coming up in the Christmas catalog is a new remote system that we're offering. We are very, very excited about this because I think that it has the possibility for bringing in a lot more people into the fold of railroading, but I think it's also going to be very attractive to a lot of train fans right now. As you can see, this is our typical Thomas remote, or Thomas the Tank Engine. The insides have been changed, though, so that it is able to run through by the commands of this remote control. The beauty of this is that it does get its power from a wall pack. It plugs into the wall that jacks directly into your terminal track. You no longer have the use for the transformer. The power that is going in is basically 18 volts. Another great thing about this is Johnny can be running this on his Thomas the Train layout, but he can also take that engine and move it over to his dad's legacy layout. Put it on there. If it's running at 16 to 18 volts, Johnny's going to be able to use his remote and control his engine at the same time. If you have one engine like this and another remote, those will be at different frequencies, and you will be able to run more than one locomotive on that track at the same time. So I think this is really huge for what we can do with kids, and just the convenience as well of some people will just as might well want to just use this remote control. This does not have a neutral, so you basically have your forward and reverse. I think that's much easier for kids to use. You have your bell and whistle buttons on that, as well as another button for your Thomas the Tank Engine, for instance. So you have Sir Topham Hatt, who will say all aboard whenever you push that button. And that is the actual recording that they use for the show. So that's really exciting. You'll see this for Christmas in the traditional Thomas scheme, but you'll also see a Christmas Thomas the Tank Engine. Thomas will have a Christmas hat, and the two passenger cars, there'll be a garland strung along the side, so it'll have a nice Christmas theme to it. And you will see, lastly, the individual locomotives as well that will be offered. So if you want to pick up Percy, for instance, you'll be able to get Percy separately.
And we will be operating these Thomas in the booth. So if you want to come and see it in operation, you'll be able to see it operating.
And one last note on that too, the pulling power of these are great. It's not like you're getting a substandard locomotive. You're getting one that's going to be able to do anything that your regular locomotives of those caliber can do. We're running, and we may be running tomorrow, 14, 15, 16, 17 cars at a time. So whatever Thomas cars you have, you'll be able to pull it behind one of these engines. Let's move into our post-war section of product. You may have noticed in our last catalog, we've titled the pages Post-War Inspired. That wasn't meant to confuse anybody or to make them think that there's a whole nother branch of post-war products. What we're trying to do is, under one umbrella, make it clear to everybody that these products that we're going to show in on those pages are all really part of the same family. We have our conventional classics, of course. We have some post-war celebration pieces that come and go. We have the archive section. Now and then there's promotional sets that never were cataloged. So there are various things that fall under that category, and we are just trying to make them all fit that post-war inspired family. A few pieces that I have here are, Ryan is pulling up right now some of the Alcos that we have. This is the U.S. Marine Corps 221. I believe that the only the A unit for this conventional classics piece, which is what it is now, was offered. The B unit we are offering as a nice support piece for the original post-war reissue that we have here. As a conventional classic, this has all of your usual conventional features with the electronic E unit, conventional control, of course. We really just try to keep these as true as we can to the original with the Pullmore motors, and just trying to keep them as pure as we can for our post-war fans. Along the same lines is the Elko U.S. Navy with the B unit. We are offering this in a promotional set. I'm not sure who the set was ultimately sold to, but it was a 1961 set that came with a variety of military type cars, like the like a submarine car and the Minuteman missile launcher, those types. A very cool set, very rare. I believe that the boxcar in this set, when it originally was produced for this set, they actually labeled the extended number wrong by adding a dash 200 to the caboose style in really a wink to that original error. We are going to have that box have that same dash 200 number behind it for the box. We also have a few archive pieces. As many of you are well aware, I believe 1948 catalog, the black bonnet that was cataloged but never produced. We have the AA unit that we're offering. These are F3s with your die-cast, you know, metal pilot and frame and fuel tank. Conventional control, though. Illuminated number boards on the front. Just a very beautiful piece. Lionel, of course, has to produce the black bonnet in its conventional classics or archive series at some point. We will be, just to keep, again, all of this stuff is part of the same family. It's fitting to take engines like this for us and also give them the older post-war style packaging, even though it never would have had packaging because it never was made. We also have the eccentric red-striped version of the New York Central F3. This was noted as having been made as a prototype for one of the Lionel showrooms. And it really is a unique piece. This is also sold as an AA set. And this is conventional control as well. Just a very, very nice piece and part of Lionel's extended history. That will also have the post-war style packaging. Some scale pieces that we have, we'll look at the Jeeps, the Santa Fe. I brought a handful of just odds and ends here that have just come in, really. I really have unboxed these for the first time. You may see in our last catalog, and perhaps the one before that, we are trying very hard to offer everyone a wide variety of different road names and options for different locomotive types that we're doing. I think for the Jeep 9s that we have here, which is very similar to the Jeep 7s we've produced in the past, with some additional venting styles that are more fitting for the Jeep 9s. Also, you'll notice here on the top too, some really unique exhaust systems along the tops, and two of these with a dynamic brake hatch on the roof, and this one without. So you've got some nice variations from piece to piece. But you know, for instance, for the Jeep 9 alone, you have Rock Island, Louisville and Nashville, Great Northern, Chesapeake and Ohio, Northern Pacific, Union Pacific, and Santa Fe will all be available. These are being have just been produced, so once they're ordered, you'll be able to pick them up very soon from your dealer. These are legacy pieces. We are, for the most part across the board, for this type of engine, offering two legacy road numbers. So if you want a double head, you can pick up your two powered units that are completely equipped with the legacy system and legacy rail sounds and Odyssey 2 speed control. Those have dual motors and electrocouplers on both ends. Very nice pieces. But if you want to save a little money, you can also pick up the non-powered third road number that's available. So if you like to double head, you'll have two choices to do so. A few other odds and ends, that's fine, thanks. Diesels is the Shark Nose, and how about that C420 too? These are sort of just odds and ends that I have here. Again, they're items that we've certainly done these in the past, and we are bringing them back with the legacy system and all the upgrades that the legacy system allows. So you're just going to have beautiful pieces. You're going to have the running capability of what we're doing in our modern systems now. Another great addition to a lot of these locomotives is the sequence control. It's a new feature that you have that really, if you want to set that with your legacy system, the sequence control allows you basically to set up a running, your engine and its features, what will be activated and not. Will the locomotive itself is smart enough to decide based on how it's traveling on your track and when you started and when you're ending, to basically give you a scenario of your bells and your smoke and your sounds and your dialogue that mimics the activities of that train on the railroad. So it's really one more added bit of realism for your train. Now, if you want to turn that off and you make all the decisions yourself, that's fine. But if you want to set it in that sequence control, it's a nice realistic feature to be able to show off to your visitors. I brought a few F units for our scale pieces as well. These are different tooling than the traditional post-war pieces. This is one of the three engines, F units, that are related to the California Zephyr. Obviously here I've got Burlington, the CBQ. We have Denver and Rio Grande that we're offering, and Western Pacific. Lionel is also offering passenger cars, 18-inch aluminums to go with these. There have been some questions about whether we are going to do a specific observation car for that. I'm sorry to say that we're going to have to stick to the tooling as we have it so that we can move forward with production on the passenger cars. I know that there are some other great passenger car series that are available out there, but we hope that the 18-inch aluminum passenger cars, we really do feel that they're a nice package to run behind any of your California Zephyr cars. Just very beautiful. Legacy, of course. Your ABU, let's see. This is a separate sale B unit. It is sold as an AA. The AAs that are sold together will have an electrocoupler on either end. There's only one powered unit. The second unit that's not powered, though, it does have your smoke features, your sound features, your electrocoupler features. So it is the enhanced version of the non-powered unit. And then I also brought one that's non-Zephyr related, yet another scheme for us for the F7 that we have here for Milwaukee Road. F7s that we're offering in 2012 are Western Maryland, Louisville and Nashville, Milwaukee and Wabash, and then for the F3s, the CBQ, Rio Grande, and Western Pacific. Oh, sure. Yeah. I had a one piece of rolling stock. I love these our Lionel scale cabooses in the CA3s and CA4s, which is a Union Pacific specific style of caboose. We've been able to do a lot with them. In part, we have Union Pacific to thank for that because they've done so many interesting things with their graphics on their cabooses. So here is a prototypical scheme of one of their safety schemes. This one says, at grade crossings, every time is train time. Be careful. All of those Union Pacific cabooses all have a nice, unique look to them, and I wanted to show this off today to you guys. This is a CA3 version. If you turn over to look at the roof, Jaden, flip that over. This catwalk and some of the grab rails that are on that cupola were not on the later versions. They had removed those for the later classes of Union Pacific cabooses. We might have to clear the space a little bit for the centipede, which I brought two different schemes. Yeah, let's over. Thank you. We have both a single stripe version and a five-stripe version for Pennsylvania. Ryan's holding, obviously, that the five-stripe version. This is the first samples that I've seen painted up. So we will be looking closely at the decoration of these and double-checking the color shades that we have on these because we want it to be just right. But as you can see, these in real life, they ran in 45 to 48 is when they were built. And they for Pennsylvania, they did often run as AA units. You're looking at over 180 feet worth of a diesel unit for that. So these are close to, if not 2 feet long for your layout. These obviously are demand a wider curve. These are 072 pieces. Jadon will attest to the fact that they are pretty heavy. This is a die-cast body. You'll have two smoke units on top, so you have smoke exhaust for both units, die-cast bodies for both units, two motors for both units, two speakers for both units. A great thing about this, and what really truly makes it vision, is the feature with the sound. You have two speakers in both engines, but both engines will not be in sync with the exact same sounds. The sounds will be, in a sense, be separated, and it really will just enhance the realism and sort of a stereo effect of the various locomotive sounds for your engines. Speaking of big pieces, you may have seen in our recent catalog, got a few odds and ends here that I just dropped. The Motor City Express, we're really excited about this set with an SD80 scale locomotive. What's really special about this set are the brand new auto carrier cars that are part of this set. As you can see, there are four as part of the set, and then two for separate sale. These also are quite long in length. You're looking at 24 inches, let's say, for each of these units. What's wonderful about these cars is they're designing them in a way so that the couplers are adjustable underneath the car. So what's going to happen is when that car goes around a curve, it's going to widen to allow you to run on tighter curves. So we're actually going to be able to get 054 as the minimum curve for these long auto carrier cars rather than what would normally be 072 for a car that length. So that's going to be a really special car for the C2 catalog. You're going to be able to buy inserts of vehicles that you could slide into the auto carrier cars. The last car in the set does have an end-of-train device light, so that's really cool. Another high-end set that the Jeep 9, didn't we have? We had a Jeep 9 that I showed you that was Canadian National. That actually is part of the piggyback trailer set for Canadian National. And I just want to make special note that that set does feature a new die-cast tractor truck that I know many of you over the years have asked us, why don't you do a truck for your piggyback trailers? That would be perfect. So we are moving forward with that. There's a lot of them for separate sale that are shown in the catalog as well, that on our page that shows the PS4 flat cars. I will say that the retail that's listed in the catalog is higher than what it ultimately is going to be. We're still in the process of quoting the set, of getting final quotes on it. And when we do have the final price for that before the order period, we'll certainly announce that publicly. And that reminds me, sorry, Jada, on this set, we actually did get the final quoting settled for the set. We're actually moving down $30 on the individual auto carrier cars. And the set itself is now at $969 rather than, I think, what it was, maybe $1,100 retail. These are very nice, very special, high-end sets, and we're doing our best to keep the prices as fair as we can and have everybody win. And so if it hasn't been announced publicly yet online, you will see that the auto carrier cars in the set have gone down in price from what is quoted in the catalog. At this point, if there's anything specific that you have questions about that I could, that we could respond to, we'd be happy to. We will be moving forward with the Norfolk Southern series. All these will be in the C2 catalog. I think there are some 18 or 19 locomotives total. And there are both SD70 ACEs as well as the ES44 ACs. Lionel will be doing them all, and we will also be offering a caboose and a freight car that will be in those same road names as well, so you can add on to those locomotives that you might be interested in. American Flyer, keep in mind we've got the straight and the curved track that we've offered. And now we've recently cataloged the switches that we're coming out with. Also the transition track. If you've got the old American Flyer track, you can connect that to the new fast track system. And be prepared as we move forward. You will see some wider curved track for American Flyer, as well as any other pieces that we feel are necessary to complete all of those, to complete those that series. Cylindrical hoppers for American Flyer as well. These are scale. If you're familiar with the O-gauge pieces, you will perhaps appreciate this as offered in S-gauge. And then one last note about the Heritage series for the SD70 ACEs for American Flyer. And don't forget two newly tooled pieces for Lionel for 2012. You'll see here an NW2 148 scale, and that'll be fully equipped with all the great legacy features, as well as the Jeep 35 that's on the bottom right here. That Jeep 35 will be brand new tooling, and of course, these types of engines are popular on so many different road names. So there's going to be a lot that we can offer over the next number of years for these types of engines. And they're not 072 pieces either. So a lot of you who maybe have smaller sets will have a chance to buy some great products.
We hope to see all of you in the booth. Come by and see what we've got going on over there.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Thank you.